Hey guys, I'm going to show you a Singapore $1,300 PC build for your gaming, streaming, and your work needs. So starting right now. Hey guys, Fema-san here, and welcome back to our channel. Because of this COVID-19 situation, most of you are probably working from home just like myself. So you'll probably be using your laptops and your MacBooks for your teleconferencing or even your game streaming needs. I don't know why, but yeah. So if you're like me and you do not like the grainy footage you have from your laptops or your MacBooks, what you can do is definitely upgrade to a better PC. So this $1,300 PC will be centered around 1. Streaming of games on Twitch or other streaming platforms, and 2. A better business looking like PC for your teleconferencing needs. So I'll be putting up the PC parts in the description box below, but I'll also be going through the parts that we're using for this $1,300 build. So let's carry on. Alright guys, these are parts that we have for the $1,300 build, so let's start off with CPU. Of course, we have the AMD Ryzen 5 3600 6 cores 12 threads processor. So this is a very tried and tested processor by us, by Typhoon Systems. 6 cores 12 threads is good enough for definitely your work needs. If you have a lot of browsers going on, like for example you have Chrome, you have Mozilla, you have a lot of spreadsheets, having the multiple threads will definitely ease the workload on your CPU. And the price for the 3600 is just nice for these needs. And of course, for gaming and if you want to plan to do video editing, having these extra threads is definitely good for your rendering capability and the amount of rendering time you need for your videos. So pairing this CPU, we have the motherboard, which is the MSI B450M Pro VDH Micro ATX motherboard. I forgot to mention that this is a Micro ATX build. Micro ATX build is good because that, for example, 1, if you find that it's taking too much space in your house, a Micro ATX is just nice. And if you plan to bring a sizable build to a LAN party, I think a Micro ATX is just nice. Of course, if you want something smaller, you can go for Mini ITX. So we have done Mini ITX builds in our channel before. For example, 1, the T150, you can check it out up there. So back to this motherboard. So this is also a very try and tested motherboard by Typhoon Systems, the MSI B450M. It's a good size motherboard for the AMD Ryzen 5 3600, so, and it's also a good price at $99. So go on to memory or RAM, we have the GSQ FlareX 16GB DDR4 3200MHz memory. Of course, for AMD, you want to have high speed memory, but with this budget, I think a 3200 is just nice. We don't need to go for a 3600. And 16GB is the norm that we need for modern day PCs. 8GB just doesn't cut it anymore. And the good thing about having this FlareX is it's specifically made for AMD CPUs. So if you're going for AMD builds, do try to check out the FlareX RAM. So let's go on to fast storage or the SSD. So we're currently using an 8L XPG SX6000 NVMe SSD. So this is 512GB. So at a price of $73, it's pretty awesome. They definitely know that storage prices have gone down these few months, but because of this COVID-19, we're not so sure, but listed on Amazon is about $73, so it's a good price. Having a NVMe on SSD on your system is definitely good because of the high rewrite speeds. So for example, for workload, if you have a lot of data, if you have a lot of sheets, documents, folders, you want to have a fast rewrite speed to send things faster. And of course, for gaming, you know that having a fast SSD enables your game to load faster. Always remember to install your OS on your SSD or your games on your SSD if possible. So next, the highlight of every gaming build is a video card. This is the MSI GeForce RTX 2060 6GB Phantom SX OC. Of course, if you are just doing this for work, you don't need to have such a GPU. You can go for something cheaper, but I think this is a good start if you plan on working and gaming after that. Something lower, just not cut it. So we have done a video on this before. We pitted this card against the MSI 5600 XT. So if you'd like to know how it fares and how it fares against its AMD rival, you can check it out also in the video up there. So this is a good size card at $340, it's pretty awesome. Yeah, check it out. So before we go to the case, we gotta go to the power supply. This is a Seasonic S12-3 650W 80 Plus Bronze power supply. So this power supply is also made for MATX cases. When building a PC, make sure to check the size of power supply first before buying it, because you don't want to have competitive issues. This I think is semi-modular, and 650 watts provides just enough juice for this PC. So now we go on to the case. Because of our budget, this is the Zimatec Spirit M METS case. We don't need to go for some fancy dandy RGB-ish case, So in this case, it's black, it also has a clear side panel. I think it's good enough for a build like this. So anyways, we have OS, Microsoft Windows 10 Home Edition. So when it comes out, it runs about $892, which is roughly about $1,200 Sing dollars. So this is the PC. Of course, if you plan to do some streaming or teleconferencing, you need something like webcam. So now I'll go on to the webcam, which we recommended by Typo Systems and I. Alright guys, for a webcam, we recommend the AVerMedia Livestreamer Cam 313 or PW213 webcam. So this is a 1080p webcam. I think it puts up footage at 30fps, which is just good enough for your teleconferencing or simple basic game streaming needs. It is a webcam where you affix it to your monitor or your laptop. Very easy to use, just connect it straight to your laptop and change some settings and your computer will then pick it up. So it also comes with this privacy security slider. If you don't want people to see what's going on webcam or you're done with webcam, it's good to have this slider to block out unnecessary privacy attention issues. Another thing about this webcam is that it comes with a mic, but it's not a stereo mic by a mono mic, so audio output may not sound as good compared if you have a separate mic like a earpiece that currently what I'm currently using right now, or a standalone mic. So this is something that you take note. But I think it's good enough if you're just using it for teleconferencing. So it will sound a bit boring, a bit plain, but it's good enough to hear what people need to hear. And yeah, you can put like emojis or whatever they call this bunny ears during your game needs, or I don't know, you want to impress your colleagues when you look like a cat. So I may be doing a video on this in the future if I get my hands on one. Check it out on my channel to see whether I do get to play with this thing. Yeah. And also, if like I said earlier about the webcam, if you find that the mono audio output sounds too plain, for example if you're playing games, we also recommend this microphone. This is the AVerMedia USB microphone AM310. So it's a standalone mic as compared to what I'm using, wired mic. It's a USB mic, you can connect it to your computer, it will pick it up like your regular voice. So I have not tried it yet, but this is recommended by Gordon for Typo Systems. So it must be good. Unidirectional sound, for example. And there is a monitoring software to monitor your sound, so you can do some audio editing, you can use it. So good for music editing, video editing, or just doing your live gameplay streams. Alright, so you have seen the PC parts and the mic and webcam recommendation. So now let's go and get on to some benchmarks, two benchmarks, to show you how the game runs in, like I mentioned, Battlefield 5 and Apex Legends. Let's go! First benchmark, Battlefield 5, the level Last Tiger. Settings are 1080p, ultra preset, DLSS off, and ray tracing off. So you can see it's doing quite well. 70-80fps, even though there's a lot of exposures going around. So one thing to note also is that this is running on DX12, DirectX12 instead of DirectX11. Because what we believe is that it's better to use a modern day API to show current benchmarks rather than use the previous DirectX11 API. So we're still doing quite well. We can see that with all this magic going on, we're still doing a very respectable 100+ FPS, very smooth gameplay. The CPU is maxed out at 4.1 GHz. And the memory usage is pretty okay also, so it's maxing out at 7 gigs. We are done. Alright, the last game we're gonna benchmark is the very popular esports title, Apex Legends. So this is the Fire Ridge mission. We cranked up settings up to max, so you can stick it up. So as you can see from the top left corner, the game is running super well at 130fps. Maxed out also at 4.5 GHz. Pretty good, because this is okay demanding game, that's why it's doing very well. So you can see the RTX 2060 Mac OC matchup with the Ryzen 5 3600 is doing pretty well in such esports titles. So if you ever want to stream such an esports title on your streaming PC, for example this PC, yeah, you can definitely do so, but remember to always stream at 720p instead because of Twitch requirements. Yep, this is definitely a very capable PC for your work, and if you ever want a game and stream, good enough budget PC to go for. So yeah. Okay, so I hope you guys like this $1,300 PC for your work stream or your game stream needs. If you do, please give me a thumbs up and let me know in the comment section below what if you will use this $1,300 PC for your build or what other PC builds that you're currently using at home. So in the meantime, make sure to watch my other videos. I recommend this video for another game stream need and make sure to click on the eye icon to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell to know when to put up new videos. So this is Realmerton out.